I'm tired of talking. Grab your coat and let's start walking. Come on, come on.
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 So, come here, big round of applause for Grandmaster Jim Brassard!
On combination number 8, which I think is a very important technique if we take a good look at it, inside and out. Now, right off the bat, it's a great expression of the rule, where the line ends, the circle begins, and when the circle ends, the line reappears. So let's take a look. He throws a punch. Now, our combination 8, normally, is we would block, we would do a front kick, and then we would turn it into a roundhouse kick, all right? And then cross and cover. Now there you go. You've got your line and your circle. Where the line ends, the circle begins. Two things. Some instructors will teach you to block, hold, trap, whatever. I would say, if you go to the average male and throw your leg down there, those hands are going to fly down out of sympathy. Okay? If you're holding on tight, I'm going to hold this gi tight, and he flies down like that, he'll control my balance and maybe begin to move the fight in his direction from this position. I would recommend double blocking it out and go to throw the kick where he'll use that hand to block, because that's the closest hand. And then bring it up, pop him in the face. Okay, one other thing about combination 8. I'm doing it for defense. I can tell you from firsthand experience, it's an incredibly successful offensive technique that I've used in tournaments, which you'll see some pictures at the end of this. Okay, if he's on guard, move back. If he's on guard, and I throw the first kick, and I sell it, and I make him think that if he doesn't block, he's going to get seriously hurt, he has opened the way for a good roundhouse kick. The key here is you have to sell this leg. You can't cheese it. He won't react to it. You've got to make him believe that when you throw the first kick block, and come up, and come around, and strike the side of the head. I used this in a tournament, 1979 or 80. 9 out of 10 times I landed it as a point. You're going to see it. Okay? I'm not moving. It's just a picture of where the guy's hands is, opposed to my foot. Now, the only trouble you'll have it as a defensive technique, if he switches sides, he's got a backup hand to block, and you might have a little trouble now with it, so we do it, that's right, left-handed, just switch it, that's all. Okay, so again, to recap, okay, it's a great lesson on learning, okay, where the line ends, the circle begins, and where the circle ends, the line reappears. For those of you that have combination 9, there you go. But I wanted to expand your horizons and show you, on God, like a fight. If you use it as an offensive technique, use it for offense instead of defense, you might find it's an exciting addition to your arsenal of offensive weapons. And it works like a charm if you sell the first kick. All right? And it just goes by the rule, line ends, a circle begins. Period. All right? There's combination 8 showing you that there are other ways to look at these techniques. You might not want to do them for defense. You might want to look at them as offensive techniques and see what you come up with. Okay? All right, that's your tip for now. You'll all see me as a young man doing this in a tournament. And then you'll see a very famous fighter that you might have heard of doing it in one of his movies. Okay, that's it for now. I'll see you in the next tip.
Thanks for watching. These videos are tremendous. You better like them too, or I'll be back.